Before we get started in today's lesson, we need to go over four vocabulary words. The first vocabulary word is central angle. A central angle is an angle formed by two radii. Radii is the plural of radius. So if we have a circle, circle P, and we have a radius PA and a radius PB, the central angle is going to be angle APB. Notice that P is the center of the circle. So a central angle has a vertex that is the center of the circle. A minor arc is a portion of the circle that is less than half. So if we look at this picture, we have a minor arc that goes from point A to point B. It's this portion of the circle. It's not the line segment AB, it's the portion of the circle AB. The notation for a minor arc. We start at point A and we go to point B, and instead of a line segment, we're going to use an arc. A major arc is a portion of the circle that is more than half. In this circle, we have a major arc that goes this way around the circle. If we look at this circle and exclude the minor arc AB, what's left is a major arc. But in order to name a major arc, we need to know which direction to go. So if we start at point A and we want to end up at point B, but we want to go this way around the circle, we need to make sure that we go this way around by identifying a point out here. So a major arc is going to be named with three letters. We're going to start at point A, we're going to end at point B, but in between we need to go through point C. And again, we're going to use an arc mark for notation. A semicircle. We have less than half, more than half. A semicircle is a portion of the circle that is exactly half. In order to get exactly half, I have to draw in a diameter. So I'm going to take PB and extend PB all the way across my circle to create a diameter. And I'm going to call that point E. So now we have two semicircles. If we start at P and go this way around the circle, all the way to E, that's a semicircle. And if we go this way around, we have a semicircle. Well, I'm going to identify this top semicircle. To identify this top semicircle, again, I'm going to start at point B, and I'm going to go all the way to point E. And in between, I'm going to hit point A along the way. Notice that both major arcs and semicircles are named with three letters. And in this case, the minor arc is only two letters. But if I had a point right here, D, I can name minor arcs with three letters. I don't have to, but I can. Arc AB is the same as arc A to D to B. Now let's talk about measuring arcs. If I take the center of a circle and its radius, and I extend that radius all the way around my circle, I create a circle. And I've taken that radius and I've rotated that radius 360 degrees, which means the measure of this arc, the measure of this entire circle, is also 360 degrees. If I take the center of a circle and its radius, and I rotate that radius, if you look at the portion of the circle that is covered by this arc, well, the central angle is 90 degrees and the intercepted arc is also going to be 90 degrees. It's going to be 1/4 of the entire circle. The entire circle is 360 degrees. A fourth of that is 90. Notice that the central angle and the intercepted arc are both the same. Well, let's use that idea and get a little more specific. If I take the center of a circle and I call that center P, and I take a radius, PB, and I rotate that radius, and I create a 35 degree central angle, the portion of the circle that I've covered is also going to be 35 degrees. So the measure of my central angle, APB, equals 35 degrees. The measure of my intercepted arc, AB, also equals 35 degrees. Well, if I look, if these both equal 35 degrees, the measure of my my central angle is going to equal the measure of my intercepted arc. This is the first formula you're going to have to memorize for chapter 10. The measure of a central angle is going to equal the measure of the intercepted arc. All right, let's use this idea to answer some problems here. KM, LN are diameters. Determine whether the arc is a minor arc, major arc, or semicircle, then find the indicated measure. So if I look at arc OL, OL is an arc that is less than half, so it is a minor arc. Now if I need to find the measure of this minor arc, I need to find the measure of this central angle. Now if I look, LN is a diameter, which means that this entire angle is 180 degrees. So if I have 75 and 50, I can take 180 and subtract 75 and then subtract 50, and what I'm left with will be the measure of this central angle. And if this central angle is 55 degrees, my arc, my intercepted arc, is also going to be 55 degrees. If I look at arc KL, KL is also less than half, so it is a minor arc. To find the measure of that minor arc, I need to find the measure of the intercepted angle. Well, 50 degrees and 55 degrees gives me 105 degrees. N to O to L. Well, NL is a diameter, which means that NOL is a semicircle, and its measure is going to be 180 degrees. If I look at OLN, even though OLN has three letters, the arc from O to L to N is actually a minor arc. So make sure you're tracing out the arc to make sure that it's a minor or a major arc. In this case, just because it has three letters does not mean it's a major arc. It's actually a minor arc. Now I need to find that measure. Well, there's some information that I haven't filled in yet. If this angle is 75, this angle here also has to be 75 degrees. So if I find the measure of arc OLM, I need the measure of these two angles added together, 55 and 75. N to K to M. Well, that's going to be a major arc. I'm covering more than half of the circle. From N to K to M, I need to add up all of these angles together to find that major arc. 75 and 50 and 55 and 75. And finally, O to M, all the way back to K. From O to M to K is going to be a major arc. Well, if I look, O, M, K is almost an entire circle. It's 360 degrees minus this arc. So I can take 360 degrees and subtract 50 to find that major arc. 360 minus 50 gives me 310 degrees.